Greetings to the viewers of this video. Hope you all are doing well. Myself Hira, instructor of today's video. In this video, we are going to see some of the methods in mixing of pharmaceutical powders. There are seven various methods used in mixing of pharmaceutical powders. They are first method, spatulation. Second method, trituration. Third method, geometric dilution. Fourth method, sifting. Fifth method, tumbling. Sixth is pulverization by intervention. The last method is levigation. Now, let us see the methods briefly one by one. 1. Spatulation. The first method is spatulation. Spatulation is the mixing of powder and a semi-solid such as creams on an ointment pad or slab using a spatula. As we use spatula for this mixing process, the name comes as spatulation. By this method, a smallest quantity of active ingredient is mixed thoroughly with a base on the ointment slab. This method is used for 1. Small amount of powder. 2. Solid substances that liquefy when in close and prolonged contact with one another. Disadvantage: spatulation is not suitable for powders containing one or more potent substances, because in spatulation process, homogeneous blending do not occur. 2. Trituration. Trituration is a form of comminution, which means reducing the particle size of the substance. It is used to reduce the particle size and also aids in mixing of powders. Trituration may be defined as the pharmaceutical process of reducing the particle size of powders through a mortar and pestle to produce fine powders. Or it can also be defined as follows. Trituration is a dilution of a potent drug with an inert diluent powder, usually lactose, in a definite proportion by weight. The diluent mostly used is starch. 3. Geometric dilution. When mixing a small amount of potent drug with a large amount of diluent, the process of geometric dilution is used. In this process, the small amount of drug is placed in the mortar with an equal amount of diluent and triturated until they are mixed well. Then, an equal amount of diluent is again added to the mixture and trituration is repeated until they are intimately mixed. This procedure is repeated until all the powders have been thoroughly mixed. 4. Tumbling. Tumbling involves mixing powders by shaking and rotating them in a closed container and in a controlled environment. It is mostly used in industrial scale mixing of powders. Tumbling is performed for mixing only extremely light powders. 5. Sifting. Powders can also be mixed by passing them through sifters, like those used in the kitchen, to sift flour. It results in light and fluffy product. It is not used for mixing potent drugs. 6. Pulverization by intervention. This method is used for powders that do not crush or triturate easily, or gummy-type substances. In this method, the intervening solvent, which are volatile solvents, such as acetone, alcohol, etc., is added that will dissolve the compound. The dissolved powder is then mixed in an ointment slab to enhance the evaporation of solvent. As the solvent evaporates, The powder will recrystallize out of solution as fine particles. 7. Levigation. Levigation is the process of grinding an insoluble substance to a fine powder while wet. The particle size of powder is reduced by 3 turating it in a mortar or spatulating it on an ointment slab with a small amount of liquid in which the solid is not soluble. Mostly used non-solvent is mineral oil. Levigation is particularly used when solute is to be incorporated into dermatological preparations. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. I will come back with another topic in the next video.